Good morning, 5th class children. Now open your course book, children, for the new chapter Smart Tables and Charts. Open page number 44, children. Smart Tables and Charts. We are already aware about the concept of data handling and tally marks. Let us revise. It once again information collected in a raw form is called data. Look here, children. You have already learned in the previous class, children, about smart tables. Smart tables means data handling and tally marks. So look here, what is data? Information collected in raw form. So the raw information is called data. The raw information is called data. Data can be represented in different ways, such as tally marks, pictographs, box charts, bar graphs, etc. Here is an example, children. Look, answer the following questions. This table shows the number of fish in 5 different aquariums. Write tally marks for this data. So here aquarium, number of fish. So aquarium 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 aquariums. And the number of fish in that aquarium are given. So we are going to write tally marks here, children. What is a tally mark? Look, children, tally marks are also called hash marks. These are used in unary numerical system. Look here, 19. So aquarium 1 having 19 fish in that. So write the tally marks for 19, children. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are 4 lines, and for the 5th line we have to draw a line like this, children. So for the 5th line we have to draw a line like this. So this bundle represents 5, number 5. Okay, next one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this total 2 bundles represent how much? 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 15. Next, 15 after 16, 17, 18, 19. So this is the tally mark. These are the tally marks for number 19. Okay, children. Next one. Aquarium 2 having 20 fish in that. Aquarium 2 having how many fish? 20. So write tally marks for number 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, next, aquarium 3 having number of fish? 24. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have to draw 4 bundles like this, children. After right, 4 standing lines. Like this. These 4 bundles represent how much? 20. After how much is there? 4. So draw 4 lines. So this represent 24. Next, 4th aquarium having 30 fish. So draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these 3 represent how much? 15. So after again draw 3 bundles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 plus 5, 10. 10 plus 5, 15. 15 plus 5, 20. 20 plus 5, 25. 25 plus 5, 30. So aquarium 4 having 30 fish. These are the tally marks for that. Next, aquarium 5 having 12 fish. So first draw two bundles and draw two lines. 1 2 3 4 5 1 2 3 4 5. So here total 10. 1 2 12. Okay, come to the next example, children. In a survey, the fruits eaten by the students of a class in a week are noted and represented in this pictograph. So this is a pictograph, children. Look here, fruits names and number of students. Mangoes, apples, bananas, oranges. Now mangoes are given, 3 mangoes. So look here, each mango represent 2 students. Each mango represent 2 students. So here 3 mangoes are given. 3 into 2 how much? 6. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 apples are given. 6 into 2. So each apple represent 2. 6 into 2, 12. Next, bananas. 6, 7, 8 bananas. So banana also represent 2. So 8 into 2, 16. Oranges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 oranges. So each orange represent 2. So 5 into 2, 10. These are number of students. So mangoes eaten students how many? 6. Apples 12. Bananas 16 students. Oranges 10 students. Now they are asking questions here, children. How many students ate mangoes? So mangoes eaten students how many? 6 students. So 3 mangoes. So each mango represent 2 students. 3 into 2, 6. Next, by what number is the number of students who ate bananas more than that of the students who ate apples? So the difference between the eaten apples and banana students. Look here, children. How many students are eaten bananas here? 16. Now how many students are eaten apples? 12. So difference means subtraction. Subtract these two numbers. 16 minus 12, 6 minus 2, 4. 1 minus 1, 0. So what is the difference between those two? 4. So 4 students are eaten more than apples. Okay, 4 students are eaten bananas more than that of the students who eaten apples. Okay, next, which fruit was consumed more by the students? Which fruit? Very good, banana. B-A-N-A-N-A, banana. Come to the next page. Next, look here, children. How to make a pictograph? So a pictograph means picture representation table is called a pictograph. So how to make that pictograph? Let us learn how to make a pictograph. A pictograph has the following parts. So look here. First part, title. A pictograph having a title. Look here in this example, varieties of apples in food store. So this is the title for that pictograph. And next, types. This column indicates types of apples. Types of apples. And this side, these are the pictures. These are the pictures. Next, key. So here this is a key. Each apple represent 10 apples. In this picture, each apple represent 10 apples. And half apple represent 5 apples. Half apple represent 5 apples. So how many parts are here in this pictograph, children? Title, types, pictures and key. There are 4. Key indicates how many number or how much quantity each picture stand for in the above pictograph. So each apple represent 10 apples and each half apple represent 5 apples. In the previous example, so here in the previous example children, so they are given key for here. So each mango represent 2 students, each apple represent 2 students, like this. This is the key for this pictograph. And what is the title here? This one, fruits number of students is the title. And this is the, what is this? So types of fruits. These are the types of fruits. And this is pictures. This is pictures. And this one is key. Okay. Now look here. Steps to be followed to make a pictograph are, write the title at the top of the graph. So write title, where is the title? Top of the graph. Write a label for each row. Write a label for each row. Write a key to tell the number or quantity each picture represents. Write a key. Write a title and write a label for each row, like this. Okay. Next, use pictures to represent equal number of items. Use pictures to represent equal number of items. Write relevant questions to the answers from the pictograph. Last one. Okay, write relevant questions to the answers from the pictograph. Let us make a pictograph now. Look, page number 46 children. Here is an example. Abhishek. He is Abhishek. Went to a bakery and collected the week wise burger sales data for the month of June. He went to a bakery and collected the week wise burger sales data for the month of June. Let us make a pictograph by following the steps we have learned. So this is the information children. Week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4. A month having how many weeks? 4 weeks. So this is the first week information. 65 burgers are sold. Second week 70. Third week 55. Fourth week 80. So here he is making a pictograph children. Look. What is the title? First write the title for the pictograph now. So week sale of burgers is the pictograph. And what is the next one? Types means here weeks. How many weeks? 4 weeks. Sale of burgers in June, 4 weeks. Next pictures. Next draw pictures and write key for that. Key. So each burger represent here 10 burgers. In this pictograph, each burger represent 10 burgers. And half burger represent half of the 10. How much? 5 burgers. Okay. Now write the questions for the pictograph. Look here. Answer the following questions. How many burgers were sold in the first week? So look here, how many burgers were sold? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 and half na. Here in the pictograph, 6 and half burgers are visible. So 6 full burgers and half burger. So 6 full burgers means each full burger represent how many burgers? Look here, 10 burgers. So 6 into 10 plus half burger represent 5. 1 into 5. So 60 plus 5. 65 burgers. Okay, come to the next one. In which week was the most number of burgers sold? So look the pictograph. Where is the burgers highest children? In the week 4, fourth week. Okay, next third question. In which week was the least number of burgers sold? It can be seen in the picture children, number of pictures. So which week children? Where is the least number of pictures in the pictograph? Third week. Yes or no? Very good. In the third week. Okay. Least number of burgers sold in the third week. Highest number of burgers were sold in the fourth week. These are the questions and answers for this pictograph, children. Okay, children. In the next video, we will continue the pictographs, charts, bar graphs, remaining concepts, children. Now, okay, children. Once again, you also take out your course book and refer up to 46 page, children. 44 to 46 pages. Okay, children. Bye.